In the realm of WWE, there are a few things that are expected. Matches are showcases of talent, when done right and when time allows. And when you're a heel, you do despicable things, including cheating to get a victory by any means necessary. And while this is a part of their character, sometimes they get caught on camera and it ruins the illusion. Allow us to show you some examples of this. Be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. Eddie Guerrero. The late and absolutely great, Eddie Guerrero is a prime example of how cheating can make you popular with the crowd when done in a certain way. While he may have started out as a mid-card wrestler in certain promotions, his abilities in the ring were never in question, and eventually he rose to the highest heights of WWE via a series of beloved and despicable cheats. If you think of a way to cheat, Eddie probably did it and got the crowd cheering the whole time. Faked getting hit by a chair? Oh yeah, he did that. Actually hitting his pose with the chair or the title belt or another item? Did that in spades. Eddie has done so much cheating that it would be wrong to label just one as his greatest, but let's talk about the one that led to him getting the WWE title. At No Way Out, he fought Brock Lesnar and as you would expect, the ref got knocked out. So Eddie being Eddie, he tried to use the title on Brock, but Brock dodged and tried to do his finisher, the F5, on Eddie. But Eddie turned it around, did a DDT on the belt, which is cheating, and then threw the belt away. Hit the frog splash later on, and he won his first main world title. This still goes down as one of the greatest moments WWE ever did.
The McMahons.
To say the McMahons are cheaters in the game of wrestling is like saying the Game of Thrones series finale was bad. We all know that, and it's not news. Sorry, Game of Thrones fans, you know it's true. Anyway, the McMahons are easily the biggest heels in the game, and have been for decades. In fact, McMahon himself, Vince, became a true heel in the eyes of the wrestling world in what led to WWE winning the Monday Night Wars. But what can we say is his biggest cheating moment? That would be King of the Ring 1999, where he and his son Shane faced Stone Cold Steve Austin for control of WWE. Gee, I wonder how that match was going to end. Obvious ending as it was, the creativeness of it was honestly rather clever. Stone Cold had the McMahons beat, and yet, as he tried to get the briefcase, someone raised it! Obviously it was someone under the McMahon's sway, but it was enough for them to win the match, and that's what matters. To them, anyway. I could talk about how Vince is cheating fans out of actual wrestling, but that's another story.
Austin stuns the boss!
Triple H.
The son-in-law of Vince McMahon is another who is a well-known cheater, and easily one of the greatest heels in WWE history. His trademark cheat is using the sledgehammer to destroy opponents. But if we're going to pick a memorable cheat that went a little beyond that, we'd have to talk about his WrestleMania match with Sting. Sting was one of the last true holdouts from the WCW era to not go to WWE. But then, the stars aligned, and Sting finally signed with WWE and had a big match with Triple H at WrestleMania. But, instead of just having a clean wrestling dream match between two titans of their brands, Triple H and Vince decided to up the ante. Triple H's old-fashioned Degeneration X came out to the arena assist him, which led to the NWO, Hulk Hogan, Kevin Nash, and Scott Hall, to rep WCW and assist Sting. This led to Mania Falls before Triple H brought out the sledgehammer to blindside Sting and take the match. Most agree it was a sour way for the match to end, which is what happens when cheating in major matches like this happens.
Kurt Angle and the Bellas.
The WWE is never above using sleight of hand to get away with a cheating victory. And two great examples of this is with Kurt Angle and the Bellas. How so? Simple. Kurt has a twin brother named Eric, and the Bellas, Nikki and Brie, are twin sisters. For the Bellas, their twin magic was their gimmick to start. They were perfectly similar before a certain surgery on one of them ended that. And as for Kurt Angle, he used his brother wearing his full ring gear to distract an opponent so that he could get a quick win one time for the title. In wrestling, there is no holding back, and no method or measure too crazy to pull off a win.
The Montreal Screwjob.
Most times when you see cheating in wrestling, it's known as kayfabe, meaning that it's in character and part of the show. but sometimes it doesn't go in that vein, and the greatest example of this kind of cheating is the Montreal Screwjob. In short, the WWE Champion at the time was legend Bret the Hitman Hart, and he was entering the last match of his contract with WWE and was going to WCW. He was told he had to lose the title to his rival, and bitter rival at that, Shawn Michaels, in the main event of a show in Canada, Hart's home country. Hart begged Vince not to let it go down that way, and Vince agreed, at the time. But when the show happened, a plot was hatched to screw Bret out of the title before he could react. Basically, Shawn Michaels put Hart in his own submission hold, the sharpshooter, and before Hart could get out of it, Vince rushed to the ring and demanded the bell be rung, ending the match in favor of Michaels. Hart, the crowd, the viewers, they were furious. Hart even punched out Vince backstage. Vince, however, used this to his advantage and created an evil dictator persona that he would wield mightily to ensure that WWE beat WCW in the Monday Night Wars. As for Hart, his time in WCW fizzled out in a non-memorable way, making the Montreal Screwjob the true end to his long and historic career.
Brock Lesnar.
Full disclosure, we hate Brock Lesnar here. He's been pushed by Vince McMahon to high heaven because he thinks he's money, he's not, and that he's the biggest attraction out there, he's not, and that he's the best fighter in the world. Let's think about that. He's not. And over the last few years, fans have been furious with all the pushes he's gotten that took spotlight away from up-and-coming talents. Which leads us to our biggest cheating moment of Brock Lesnar's career. We preface this by saying that technically this wasn't cheating, but it sure felt like it. The year was 2019, and the event was Money in the Bank. The Money in the Bank ladder match is one of the most anticipated events of WWE's year because the winner, who climbs a ladder to retrieve a briefcase, can cash in that case to get a guaranteed world title shot anytime they want. The 2019 event had a lot of up-and-coming talent. And for almost a half hour, those superstars were putting their bodies and lives on the line to deliver a great match. Then, at the end, when Mustafa Ali was just about to get the briefcase, Brock Lesnar came out, threw him off the ladder, and got the briefcase for himself. How is this cheating? Quite simple. He wasn't in the match to begin with! He was not booked for the match, his name was not stated or associated with the match in any way, and the only reason he came out was because one member of the match, Sami Zayn, had been taken out beforehand, leaving a vacant spot. Putting Brock in there was wrong, unsatisfying, and the crowd and internet hated it. But who loved it? Vince McMahon. The biggest gripe though was that Brock literally was in the match for a minute. He came down to the ring, knocked Ali off the ladder, and then grabbed the briefcase. That's cheating the match, the fans, the viewers at home, and wrestling in general. And fans had to watch every excruciating moment. So what did you think? What did you think about these times WWE heels got caught on camera cheating? Are you surprised by how obvious their cheats were? What is your favorite cheat from WWE history? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.